see this in the part 2 we will see again. See, mass of exhaust is equal to mass of air plus mass of fuel. Okay, then this is we have got standard equation MF MA by MF plus 1, because we are using this, there is a bracket here, we are using this formula MA by MF because this MA by MF is given, air fuel ratio is given 32 directly, mass of fuel is known, so this is easy to solve. That is why MF MA by MF plus 1, this bracket close. So this is the way you solve the mass of exhaust. Now to find out the mass of steam in the exhaust, they have given that per kg 1.35 kg of steam is formed per kg of fuel. So we know now it is only 0.076 kg per minute of fuel. So 1.35 into 0.76 is 0.1026. So this is the amount of steam produced per kg of per this 0.076 kg of fuel. Now actual mass of dry gases is 2.5 minus 0.1026, that is 2.4 kg per minute. So heat loss to exhaust gases is 2.4, Cp is 1, delta T is 300 minus 25, that is 661 kilojoules per minute. Heat carried away by steam is equal to, see now the heat carried away by steam is very important here because this is in superheated state. So now this is mass of steam. This is now the enthalpy, how we are calculating enthalpy of the saturated gas MHG plus now superheated ke liye Cp T sup minus T saturated. Okay, so mass of steam is 0.1026 calculated. So this is kilojoules 2.09. This is the he has given Cp of steam is given in the problem only is given. Please understand if Cp is not given, I remember it as 1, 2, 4. 1 is for exhaust gases, 2 is for the steam, and 4 is for the water. Okay, very simple. 1, 2, 4. 2 is superheated is equal to 2 exhaust, that is 300 degrees centigrade by data. From steam tables corresponding to the pressure of exhaust of 1 bar, T saturation is 99.63 and the enthalpy of saturated vapor Hg is 2675 kilojoules per kg. So, substituting this value Hg in this, you get 0.0126, sorry it is wrong here, this mass of steam it should be 0.01, it is 0.1026 into Hg is 2675 enthalpy of gas plus 2.09 Cp T sup minus T saturated 99. So you get as 317 kilojoules per minute. Now drawing the heat balance chart on minute basis, you can heat supplied is 3344, that is 100%. Now this is 3344 is 100%. So 714 heat loss to BP, friction, cooling water, exhaust gases, steam also is given here extra one. So this unaccounted losses is equal to this 3344 minus all these things 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now how you got percentage? 714 divided by 3344 into 100, that is 21%. Now this is 208 divided by 3344 into 100%. 100 is equal to 6.24. This is how you are going to calculate all this heat balance heat. So the heat should be balanced. Whatever left side supplied, it should be the expenditure. Now again, we will see the this steam equation only. We will see heat carried away by steam. How he has calculated is enthalpy of the gas plus Cp T sup minus T saturated. So this is the enthalpy into the mass of the gas steam. Okay. This is not 0.01, it is 0.1026. Okay, into this enthalpy of the gas, how we got? Now he has taken 1 bar pressure, for 1 bar pressure, the normal atmospheric pressure, the saturation temperature is almost 100 degrees centigrade or 99.63. Okay, that is there. And for that, this in the steam table, enthalpy of gas, dry saturated gas is only 2675. This is the dry saturated gas he has taken. Now for superheated condition, you have to multiply this T superheated minus T saturated into the Cp. So Cp is given as 2.09. Superheated means the exhaust temperature, exhaust is going in superheated condition only. So the temperature of steam is equal to the temperature of exhaust, that is 300 degrees centigrade. And the T saturation is 100 degrees centigrade. So this way you calculate the Cp of exhaust and the heat carried away by the steam. Okay, thank you.